Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Bastard Slot. Welcome back to Pleistocene Park, our Arctic tundra-inspired park filled with creatures from the Pleistocene era, and also filled with creatures not from the Pleistocene era by the time we get to the end, and also a pit. Right, so in today's video, we're going to add the Columbian Mammoth to our park. We're going to move away from the big old cliffs and islands for a bit. We're going to go land over here, and we're going to build like a nice, normal-ish habitat. We're still with some cliffs, because cliffs are cool, but more normal. Maybe, we'll see. Before we get onto that, though, thank you so much for leaving all the name suggestions in the QT. Again, that's linked in the description down below. If you want to name any of the mammoths in this video, hit me up on that QT. And in today's video, we have Indopentaceratopses, which are Leptobus. We have Dunce of the Pit, Big Bill, Daisy, there she is, exploring the forest, looking very beautiful. Beef, Fuzz Knuckle, spelled incorrectly, but I wasn't sure if it was on purpose, so I left it like that. Joe, there's Joe, dead. Terminator, Boss, which was came up multiple times, and Dunce of the Pit. Lots of very to-the-point names today. Anyways, using Siaka's, God, I hope I remember that correctly, Mammoth mod, again, linked down below in the description, we are going to make some Camarasauruses, which have been replaced by Mammoths. Again, these are older mods, they're not all necessarily going to add new creatures to the game as opposed to replacing existing ones. Now, I cannot remember if there is colour variation in these things. I don't think there is, but in case there is, we're going to stick a few different colour variations in there as well. Now, let's get to work. First things first, you'll notice I fixed the gap. I had many comments about this, and I totally understand. So I fixed, there's a teeny tiny little gap there, which is why these didn't work with a single track, and that's been sorted out since. We're going to build over here. I like the idea of doing something we have never done before, which is carving our way into this part of the mountain a little bit, just because we've never been able to do it before. This is something brand new to the game. And we're going to build an exhibit partially inspired, or at least the initial idea, by an exhibit I saw Evo Squared do, who is a exceptionally talented Jurassic, probably the best, actually, in my opinion, Jurassic World Evolution builder out there. So if you want to go check out their channel, you definitely should do. And what they did was make an exhibit that felt like it actually had a covered, roofed sort of area. It was like an actual shelter, and it was really, really cool. Also, I love that we can do this. That makes me very, very sexually happy. Right, so the plan, if I remember correctly, which I definitely don't, is to grab the monorail. We've done this before, something very similar, but we're gonna do it differently, which is informative, I know. We're gonna grab our monorail track, and basically we're gonna stick these together. So let me think with my brain hole. I want these to be quite large, because basically you're gonna put the, this is the roof of the enclosure, essentially. So you want it to be, I kind of want this bit here, this whole area, to be the mammoth sleeping area slash chill zone. So we do that, and then all we have to do is keep attaching more of these together. This is gonna be a pain in the ass. And just trying to get these as close as possible without them sticking together. Okay, I'm going to say that's big enough and a little bit neater than last time. So let's give this another go. I'm just going to flatten from this back end here, because the wall is going to have to come forward anyway. And hopefully, as this comes forward, it's not going to... Yeah, there we go. So basically your shelter can essentially have a wall at the back of it, which is pretty sweet. I'm going to bring it down a little bit. Okay, now the trick, however, is going to be covering like that, but not going so close to the edge. So you kind of have to go like this, I think. See what I mean? Just dodging these little, the little bits at the side. And what we'll have to do is put trees and stuff in there and a little bit more rock texture and stuff to try and hide the edges as much as possible. Let's get as close as we can, and then we're going to curve around. It's a cool idea. It's a little bit finicky, but it's cool. Cool things are cool. I'm going to go for a slightly smaller brush. It's funny how this was never possible before. Is this not possible? I guess you couldn't get your things steep enough in the past to make this work, really. You need nice, steep mountains like we've got here. I curl around the front a little bit. Just try to make it so it looks like there's just one opening right there in the middle. Okay, so I think the trick to making this look good. Get me that good. Is to is to cover the thing in trees. Absolutely smother it in trees. So let's do that. Hopefully, it's gonna cover it just a little bit. It's gonna make it look a little bit smaller because of all the bushiness, but that's okay. That's okay. As long as it looks like the dinosaurs have an indoor area for themselves to explore, which it does, sort of, fish. It's not bad. It's not super work, but it definitely, I think it looks a little bit better in Evos, and I think that might be, at least in part, because of the ground texture and also the lighting. You can get this, so if I built it so the sun was facing a different direction, basically, there would be less light over here, so it would look, I think it would look a little bit better, basically, if the light wasn't shining in this direction. What we could do, let me just try this out as well, is build a massive mountain and block out the sun. Where's the sun coming from? I never know in this game, honestly. Oh, see, even already that's having a little bit of a negative impact down here. We need to knock that back down. Thank you very much. Oh, no, no. Everything's gone terribly wrong. Flat. No, flat. Oh, I'm on rays. Like, game, why aren't you listening to me? Oh, no, the game's doing exactly what I told it to do. That's okay. Let's bring that back down, shall we? It's all right, yeah. I'm not gonna, you know, write home about it, but it's pretty cool. It's also a cave idea she did, which was pretty awesome as well. The thing I like about this, and it's referenced in the video, is it feels just a little bit more like an actual zoo, you know, with an indoor-outdoor sort of location. I also want to build a moat, which is something we've never been able to do before, but we can now do. So we're gonna have like a curved exhibit around here. Decent size. They are mammoths. Just not the biggest moat in the world, but. Little baby moat. Little baby moat. Little baby moat. Is that a baby moat? Oh, it's a big boy moat, actually, isn't it? It's a little bit deeper than I intended, but they are mammoths. That's pretty awesome, I've got to say. Big shout out to Eva. That's cool. Big fan. Right, so we've got this kind of slightly, it's a little bit elongated. On the left-hand side, so we need to make sure we've got stuff over there. Do like a little indentation over there. But tell you what, let's get some blimmin' mammoths. I think we can actually get super cheeky, and we don't even have to put a fence there, technically. Let's see. Anyways, in case you've never seen it before, this is the Colombian Mammoth mod, if I installed it, which I did. I'm very proud of myself. Very cool. I've got to say, I love the monorails in this game, because the game lacks verticality entirely, especially in its default form before these mod tools.
No problem.
And having something like the monorail just adds to that verticality in a way we never really get. I really like how this looks. Oh, this is going to be such a cool park. Right, okay. I think I'm going to put a small fence in. I don't think it's necessary, but I think it'll look better. I think you wouldn't get away with this in real life, because children would die, basically, and people dislike that kind of thing, so. Just wanna. I wanna try to smooth this out just a little bit. It's not making me happy. It doesn't spark joy. Nice natural curve around the habitat. Cut out the parts of the video where I get annoyed and swear at the game for being stupid. And there we go. Oh, God damn it. This little bit over here is my only problem, child. It's just. It's all like super flat and level over there, and here it's just, it can't have that. Can I have that, son? Can I have that at all? Thank you. Make sure it's smooth all the way around. There we go. It looks like a proper zoo exhibit. It's a very strange feeling. This isn't something we get to do in Jurassic World Evolution, so. Put some snow on there. Snow/sand. and bring some rock in at the edge. Like so. And a little bit of cheeky snow at the top. Snow falls on the top. Snow obeys physics, usually. So, snow can settle up there. We'll mix that up in a second, but well, what's this cheeky little thing? What are you pointing out for? I like it, it's cool. Right, mammoths. One of them is dead. That's okay. No, I mean, technically all of them are dead, I suppose. You're a very slightly different colour, aren't you, buddy? Are you? Yes, I think it's slightly lighter, right? Yeah, very cool. So it looks more like a family unit. There's some slight variation there rather than clones. Now, technically, they are clones, but that's neither here nor there. Come on, guys. Let's get a move on. Chop, chop. That's taking ages. Right, I'll give those a second. Okay, next step is to actually make this look a bit more like an actual habitat. I don't think I'm going to be able to get away with viewing... Oh, I was wrong. Never mind. Didn't think that would attach on, but doing it rather. Oh right, yeah. See, that's what I expected to happen. Okay, we can't have fume galleries. Not there. What I think I need to do is install. Somebody did recommend this, and it's a good point. But if you install the invisible fences mod, you could block off areas like this, and it would still look like it's one habitat, even if in reality it isn't. Ah, oh, would have been cool to put that in there. Just to stop them doing this, basically. That would be nice. And it would still look like it does, but it would be a little bit more controlled. Right, what I think I want to do is put in these, but not attached, onto the actual fencing. Okay. What are you trying to fly? Oh, it's because it's near the edge. I remember. Okay, let's try to get these... God, that is not a semicircle, is it? No, stop! Oh, it's fine. Never mind. It's like it does the damage, but then you can fix it anyway for some reason. I don't know why it would be like that, frankly, but... Oh well, here we go again. There we go. Okay, and then we need to make a very nice looking path. So we're gonna get a big fancy boy path. That's gonna curve not obnoxiously, hopefully. Right down there. Okay. I'm really surprised that can go there. But not gonna complain. Let's drag that out. Do the same over there. Okay, don't really know what I'm doing, quite frankly. This is not my area of expertise, but that's okay. I think we're gonna put the monorail... I'd like to keep it so it doesn't all go mental. Like, a little bit of mental is okay. But if we kind of edge up the mountain a bit more, it should look a little bit more chill, you know? Try to time that so the path goes through, like so. And then we're going to put this in the middle. So you get to really see the mammoths as you arrive. God damn it. They keep ruining my lovely little river. Finally! Right, there we go. Bloody Nora. It took freaking ages. Okay. I don't really know what I'm doing, as I say. So close. Mammoths! The mammoths look cool. The exhibit obviously needs... Get out of there. The exhibit needs a little bit of love, but... I like the idea a lot. It's cool. Let's move that out a little bit. I mean, the food's up here, the water's up here. I mean, the water's down there as well, which I guess is the problem, really. Why is path... Oh, yeah, of course you do. Whoopsie-daisy. Right, how do we make this path look fancy? Can we just straight up connect it?
Okay.
Okay. And let's just grab a little bit more of this. We'll just take this to the end. If you want to, you know, wander down there and look at my moves, you can do just that. Not either judge-ish. Might have to block off that edge as well to stop it looking quite so daft, but... Right, let's get some trees. We need some trees here. Particularly here at the edge. If you can't see the join... Also, it shrouds it in a lot more shadow, which is really helpful, actually. Let's get the, let's get trees. There we go. There we go. I really like that, actually. It's a great idea. It really is. A little bit around the Pippa pool. Go. And I think these are big. We need a big boy tree. Maybe we don't need a big boy tree. I mean, we do. Everyone needs a big boy tree, even if they don't realize it, but it's because it's so near this edge. You can't put anything down right there. So we're going to have to stick with normal trees, unfortunately. Don't want to block the view too much. Alright! Mammoths! I don't know what else to add, really. It looks great! I'm gonna get rid of some of these. These are blocking the view of the shelter area. It's a cool idea. We need more things. I need, you know, toys and stuff. The rocks, even, are really hard to fit in just because they can't go... Oh, sweet. I was just wondering if I could block this off just with rocks, like to the point where the mammoths decide not to go down here. It's clearly not going to work, but a boy can dream, can't he? Oh, this game hates me. Get down there, you cheeky little blighter. Well, there we go. There we go. You're being very nice. Let's grab that one. Yeah. I feel like I should make the path fancier. This isn't really my area. Okay, after a little bit of TLC, we have our completed mammoth habitat. The path stuff is sloppy and not that exciting to watch, so I didn't include it, and I'm very sorry about that. But yeah, well, look, can I fix that? Is that gonna hate me forever? Oh, very cheeky, very cheeky. Right, yeah, so it's just a nice looking little thing. It'd be really cool if they didn't keep hanging out down there, but they're pretty insistent on doing so, so... I really, really, really like the small fence. I think that adds actually so much quality to it. It's crazy what a difference something so seemingly meaningless can make, but it does look like, you know, you could go to a zoo and see this as an elephant habitat, a giraffe habitat or something. The big moat, the shelter in the background, the feeding areas, and then the big old mammoths that you can check. Well, not the mammoths, obviously, but the animals you can watch and observe and... Yeah, there you go, folks. That is our mammoth habitat. So, we have many, many more animals left in the list. I'm going to do something a little cheeky. So, like I said, I don't want to go too hard on, you know, this island idea, but I do like the idea of having this sort of like... Ooh, that's too big. Of like crevices that go along the park. Like I say, like there's been some tectonic activity or something like that, so I'm just going to bring that not too far over there, because what I want is for you to be able to walk to the next habitat. So we're going to flatten that back up. And we'll put some boundaries there and stuff like that, but you'll walk past, and you'll walk past this little indentation over here. And if I can go small again, teeny tiny, teeny tiny. I'd like to go in that gap there and do a little bit over there as well. Oh no. What I wanted to do was try to avoid the monorails floating, essentially. Not really any other way to put it. They can like be jammed into the earth a little bit. Don't have to be fully in there, but I just don't want them to be floating over nothingness in this area if it can be helped. Which it probably can. I'd love to just ease in this gap though. Oh, it's not gonna bloody work, is it? There we go, there we go. Yeah, very cool. Very cool. So that's kind of what I want, you know, walking amongst the edge of all these precipices and stuff like that, all, you know, well protected. But that, maybe there'll be another helicopter here, and then the whole thing will be blocked off and we can monorail to the next area, something like that. But I've said so many times in this video. That is our mammoth habitat. Big shout out again to Evo Squared. I will link their video, as I say, in the description down below. Much more talented than I am at this game. Go check out their builds and stuff for sure. And I will see you lovely folks. We need more trees. I will see you lovely folks in the next habitat. Now remember, come on, you're not going to give me trees, are you? Remember to leave your mammoth name suggestions in the QT, which is linked down below in the description. And if you have any ideas for things you would like to see for future habitats, even things you think, oh, that would be a cool thing to try and build, you know, if it's not been done before, then feel free to let me know down below as well. I am at your beck and call, as they say. Well, they don't, but they should. Sorry. I get distracted by little things. Right, there we go. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much of as always. There's a mammoth. Oh, I should show the mammoth a little bit more. There's a mammoth. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Thought we'd end with some just nice scenic shots, essentially, so. Realised we didn't spend much time with our actual mammoths. I'm going to have to cut this video pretty heavily. It's been nearly an hour now. This took a long time to put together, but I get to see the mammoths do their mammoth thing. You're walking towards the precipice, my friend. If you could stop, that would be fantastic. I need to fix that over there. You're just going to go for it, aren't you? I'm going to download the Invisible Fence mod. My concern with it is I think it replaces this fence. I'm going to have to double check which one it replaces. Because if it's this one, that looks really nice. I don't want to replace it. If it's the electrical small one, which I think it might be, then we will replace it. We'll use a different fence instead for those situations. Scenic. Theming. I was tempted to maybe flatten this area more and put the feeder in there. Because at the moment there isn't any reason for them to actually use the shelter. They're not going to be drawn into there for any purpose. Maybe we could put a little bit of water in there, because every now and again they'll use it, even if it's not going to be a particularly common occurrence. What are you doing over here? That's pretty cool. Go check in on the pit mammoths. Even this is okay. If they had a nicer way to get up and down and they like consistently used it, I don't think I would mind this. I think this is quite nice. Especially with the, you know, the monorail curving over there like a roller coaster and the viewing area there and the pit walls and everything. It's got quite a nice epic dramatic sort of quality to it. It's just they act like Skyrim mountain goats or horses when they go up and down, so. Room in here. Yeah, that's pretty sweet. It looks like a shelter anyway. When you can't see it from the top and you see all the light bounding in, it looks a lot more like a shelter. This looks like a little home that they would use, which I think is pretty nice. Love what the monorail's done there. Absolutely crazy little loop. That apparently not too curvy. All the others were, which I think is nonsense. There they are. Okay, there we go. What are you doing with your foot, buddy? Oh, you're okay now. Another 3 minutes of bonus mammothy goodness. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye.